Okay, we have two nonlinear inequalities on the spot. The first one is x squared over 3x plus 4 is greater than 1. And for the second one, we have x squared is greater than 3x plus 4. And guess, 1, 2, 3, 4. And guess, the difference between the first one and the second one is that it looks like we just multiply the 3x plus 4 on both sides. Yeah. So are we just going to end up with the same solution? Well, I will have to tell you, be careful. Because the moment that you multiply or divide across the inequality, sometimes you have to switch signs because you don't know what x is, right? Because you may have some negative values or not, I don't know. But I can tell you though, if this was just equations, then they are the same thing, I will tell you that. Anyway though, let's do this one first, because if we don't have like fractions, it's usually easier. So let's look at this one right here first. Right here, let me just move these two things on the other side. Do not divide the 3x plus 1 both sides, so don't do that. Move this to the other side, we are looking at x squared minus 3x minus 4 is greater than 0. And then go ahead, factor it, we get x minus 4 times x plus 1 is greater than 0. Well, now we have to look for the numbers that we care. Right here, we care about 4. Right here, we care about negative 1. So two numbers that we care, but we don't want to include them because it's greater than. I know it sounds kind of bad, huh? We care about these two numbers, but we don't want to include them. That's just life. Anyway, here, draw the number line, put a negative 1 to the left because it's smaller, and then the 4 right here. All right, open circle, because we are not including this and that. Now pick a number less than negative 1, let's say negative 2. Put it here, negative 2 times, negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6, is negative. Put it here is negative, negative times negative, we get positive. Then we do the same thing, pick a number between negative 1 and 4, let's say 0. Put it here, we get negative, put it here, we get positive, negative times positive is negative. Pick a number bigger than 4, let's say 5. Well, this is positive, and this will also give us positive. Together, it's positive. As you can see, we care about the positive parts, which is this and that. So the answer for this is x is less than negative 1, or the other one is x is greater than 4. Right? So two different intervals. And now let's write the interval notation, which we have negative infinity to negative 1. Do not include the negative 1. Union, we go from 4 to infinity. So it depends on how you would like to present the answer. Usually it's in the interval notation once we are in the pre-calculus class. But don't forget these notations as well. All right, now how are we supposed to deal with this? The problem is, when we have the 3x plus 4 on the bottom, you have that extra cut point, right? Because here, x cannot be equal to negative 4 over 3, because that will make the bottom equal to 0. So too bad. That is the trouble number 2. But earlier, when we have nothing on the bottom, don't worry about it, right? So keep this in mind. Now, let me show you guys a safe way to do this. Firstly, put the 1 to the other side. We are going to get x squared over 3x plus 4, and then that will be minus 1, and that will be greater than 0. Next, we are going to combine the fractions. Here we need a common denominator, which is 3x plus 4, and let's also multiply that on the top as well, 3x plus 4. So altogether, we can put them together. Altogether, we have 3x plus 4 on the bottom. On the top, this is x squared. And then distribute the negative 1. We get negative 3x minus 4 is greater than 0. As you can see, on the top, we get x minus 4 times x plus 1. Over the bottom, we have 3x plus 4. And that's greater than 0. Here, we have three factors to consider. This, this, and that. All right, so here are the numbers that we care. From this, we care about 4. From here, we care about negative 1. And from here, again, you just put it to be 0. That's how you find out the numbers you care. Move the 4 to the other side, divided by 3, x is equal to negative 4 over 3. So we also care about negative 4 over 3. We care about all this, but we do not want to include that because it's just greater than, there's no equal sign. If there was an equal sign, then we are going to include the 4. We are going to include the negative 1. But we will still not include the negative 4 over 3 because that's on the bottom. That's just the reality when you have the expression on the bottom. Okay, here we go. From the smallest to the biggest. This right here is the smallest, which is negative 4 over 3. Next, we have negative 1. Next, we have 4. Let's put it down right here. Okay, pick a number less than negative 4 over 3. Let's say negative 2. Put it here, negative. Put it here, negative. Put it here, negative. Altogether, negative. Next, this right here is a little bit trickier. This is like negative 3 over 3, right, for the negative 1. Oh, by the way, open circles for all of this, right? To pick a number in between of this and that, man, let's pick negative 3.5 over 3 for this, right? Negative 3.5 over 3. Yeah. All right. When you put this on the bottom, we get positive. Negative put here is negative. This is less than negative 1, so this is negative. So together, again, when we put this right here, we get negative. When we put this right here, it is negative. But on the bottom, when we put this right here, the 3 cancel. In fact, we get positive. So altogether, we get positive. I forgot what I said earlier, but the result is positive for that. All right, next, pick a number from negative, between negative 1 and 4. Let's say 0. Put it here as negative. Put it here as positive. Put it here as positive. So altogether is negative. Lastly, pick a number bigger than 4. Let's say 5. Positive, positive, positive. So positive. Yeah. It's good that we don't have signs like you know, positive, positive, or negative, negative. Like it alternates. And the reason for this to happen is because you don't have any like even degrees here, even power. So, yeah. But anyway, do the sign chart is the safest way. Now, in order for us to get positive, we care about this and that. So the answer, I'll just write this in interval notation. We get negative 4 over 3 to negative 1, and then union 4 to infinity. So as you can see, these two things are quite different. Also, they have one part being the same though, but the other parts, no. And again, these are interval notations. We are not including endpoints right here. So let me emphasize that with red. Yep, that's it. So practice this kind of questions, especially when we have a rational inequalities. I know it's tricky, but just do it the safe way. You will be able to do it too. That's it.